Hola amigos, hoy vamos a continuar aprendiendo trabalenguas y veremos hoy nuestro quinto trabalenguas, ¿sí? El quinto. Y este trabalenguas también es bien sencillo, pero también nos dará la oportunidad de aprender nuevo vocabulario y rever y practicar algunas de las reglas y gramaticales que ya hemos aprendido. What I just said in Spanish is that today we will learn our fifth tongue twister in Spanish. And this tongue twister, which is a quite easy one, will give us, nevertheless, the opportunity to learn some new vocabulary, some new words, and also to review some grammar that we have already learned before, okay? So it's going to be also a practice and review lesson, and we will as well be able to practice and train our pronunciation in a fun way, right, with tongue twisters. So, vamos a empezar entonces a ver las palabras que estaremos utilizando en este trabalenguas. Let's begin learning the words that we will be using in this tongue twister. En means in, right? In, for example, en la caja, in the box, en casa, at home, okay? Está en el hotel. He is in or at the hotel. So, en means in or inside, right? En el este. El means the. Este here, the word este means the east. Okay? The east. Remember that these the directions in Spanish, east, west, north, south, they are written with the lowercase letters, okay? Sometimes you can see that they are written in capital, but only just to avoid confusion, right? However, grammatically, as a rule, it should be written in lowercase, right? So, este means the east. East, okay? Now, este, when it has a tilde here on top of the I, means this one, okay? Unlike when we have este, like here, but means something different, este without a tilde means this. For example, este libro means this book. However, este with a tilde means this one, right? This one. Está, and here I forgot to write the tilde here. There should be a tilde on the A, right? Because the word here is está. So, en el este, este está. Está is the third person of the singular conjugation of the verb estar, which is to be, the verb to be. Okay? So, in the east, this one is, or this one is in the east, right? Está, again, means is este, this one, en el este, in the east. Está este en el este, pero means but, right? Pero no tengo dinero, but I have no money. Pero te dije que no, but I told you no, or I said no, okay? So, pero means but. Este, this one again, donde, where, está, is, or is it, right? So, you can see that in Spanish, there is two, we can say actually, este está or está este. We can actually put the subject before the verb or the subject after the verb, okay? So, those Spanish allows both ways of speaking and writing. However, there is one way that is although correct, it is awkward. So, we usually do not use it. It looks a little bit awkward or complicated, and it's not really much used, okay? Except in tongue twisters and some literature, right? So, en el este, este está. We would say, usually, está este, right? But for the stump twister, we say este está, and it is also correct, although it is not really very much used. Está este en el este would be the usual way of speaking, right? First the verb, later the subject, okay? And then the predicate. Pero este donde está? But this one, where is it, right? So what we want to say here is, this one is in the east. Then again, this one is in the east, but where is this one, okay? Or but this one, where is it? So, vamos ahora, que ya conocemos las palabras que utilizamos en este trabalenguas, vamos a leerlo primero despacio y luego más rápido. Now that we know the words that we'll be using in this tongue twister, let's begin reading slowly and then gradually we'll be reading faster. Comencemos a leer, let's begin to read, en el este, este está. Está este en el este, pero este, ¿dónde está? En el este, este está. Está este en el este, pero este, ¿dónde está? En el este, este está. Está este en el este, pero este, ¿dónde está? Okay? So, I guess the challenge here is to alternate between este, está, este en el este, okay? Supongo que el desafío está entre la alternación de este y está, ¿verdad? So, this tongue twisters will help you to train your pronunciation, your fluency, and as well, the learning the tongue twisters is a more fun opportunity to review grammar and learn new words. Lo que dije recién es que los trabalenguas nos darán una oportunidad muy buena para entrenar nuestra pronunciación y también tratar de ir volviéndonos cada vez más fluidos en nuestro hablar. Y también iremos viendo nuevo vocabulario, nuevas palabras y reviendo algunas de las reglas gramaticales que ya hayamos aprendido. Así que sigan esperando las clases de trabalenguas que iré presentando de forma regular. Creo que será una manera mucho más divertida de ir aprendiendo gramática y nuevas palabras. Y si tienen sugerencias pueden enviármelas y las tendré en cuenta para las clases futuras que iré armando. Gracias por mirar y nos vemos en la clase que viene.